Welcome back to the Maximum Lawyer Podcast. I'm Tyson Mutrix. Jim is on assignment, and I've got Nicole Christie now. We're going to talk about MaxLawCon 2021. Hey, Nicole.
Hi, how are you?
Doing well. How are you doing?
I am alive and well. I don't take that for granted.
Damn straight. That's I love it. So let's jump in on your topic, and it's niche marketing strategies. And you've definitely got a niche marketing strategy. So tell us about first, what's your niche, and then how did you come to this topic?
So I do child protection within our state. It's the child protection agency is called DCF. And I came across this actually by a former coworker who suggested, because I worked for DCF, that it's probably an interesting niche that I should, you know, look into. And who knew that it would take off the way that it did? It's about 80% of what I do. And there's so many different areas within this particular niche. So just by virtue of mentioning the word DCF, I am getting people to recognize my name with DCF. And it's been very, very profitable for us. And just, I see a lot of success in this area.
And you're going to talk about just how you, I'm assuming that you're going to be talking about in your talk, how you've niched down and how you've really marketed that niche.
Yes, yes. One of the things that I want to share with folks is how to find that niche. And I know there's a lot of discussion about, you know, ways to niche down. And at first I thought maybe go with something I like, but I've realized that you need to actually find what you're good at. And so sometimes it could be different. But once you find that, how to find the different markets that will benefit you in getting the word out. So it's been an interesting journey, but I am very grateful because I did find a niche that I just happened to be very good at.
And I don't know, I mean, and some people might not have completely understood what you mean by that. It's like, it's child protection. Like you're representing the child, like not the parents, right?
Actually both. So child protection, basically it's any area where a parent is accused of abusing their child or neglecting their child. So I could represent a child, and that's if I have a court-appointed case, and I don't have too many of those. So the majority of my caseload is where I represent the parent who's been accused of some type of child abuse or neglect. So defending their rights around that, trying to get the child back into their care if the child has been removed, or just sometimes the investigation in and of itself is scary for parents because here's this agency that could remove my child showing up at my door. And DCF is tough to deal with. They use, you know, everything a parent says against them if they can. And so they just really do need an advocate. And it's a scary world when someone's there that could remove your child. And that's why this niche has been so unique for us.
So, I mean, this is something where, and I, we've talked about this before in the Guild, and it's, I mean, it doesn't sound like there's a lot of cases when it comes to this. So are there, I mean, were you resistant? Were you hesitant to niche down this much whenever you finally decided to do it?
No, actually, it broadened my horizons from my firm. So when I first opened, I thought I was going to do work around churches, which is still what I do, but it's not as much. And I thought I would do family law, which I then discovered the drama between mothers and fathers is not easy to deal with. But this particular area, it's huge. And so what people, you know, may not realize, when you find a niche, you have to actually, you know, dig into that niche and you'd be surprised. So within DCF, dealing with DCF, there's also grandparents who want to get custody and they have to go through probate court, who then relies on DCF to do that. So I do that type of work. You may have relatives who want to intervene on behalf of the child. And so I do some of that type of work. You have out-of-state parents who get summons or petition, you know, at their doorstep and they don't know what to do because they're actually out of state. So there are a lot of different areas. So we've actually broken ourselves down into different divisions, just dealing with DCF. Investigations is a monster unto itself. They've got 45 days. So if you don't stay on top of that, the case could go left really quickly. So we've been able to build an entire, you know, law firm around that, just dealing with DCF.
Do you find that now that you've niched out, you've got more or less competition?
I think the competition was always there. So I don't think that it's particularly changed. There's only a handful of attorneys that are known for doing this. And that was another key issue, is that a lot of those aren't really advertising. I may have one or two that are advertising. And so it's been interesting because, again, you have DCF offices throughout the state. And so what I did was, rather than just focus on one particular area, the county that my office is located in, I've just expanded it to the entire state. And therefore, getting the different calls, it just works. With everything being online, we've got cases that are an hour and a half away from me, and I sit here and take care of that case. So it's been very beneficial to us.
I love it. All right, two more questions. The first one is, what are you excited about when it comes to MaxLawCon 2021?
I'm definitely excited about seeing the folks in person. I have not been able to really go to many activities. I've been, resistant to doing so. So it'll be great to see the folks that we see just on video. I've never seen them in person, so I think that would be cool. And I think just meeting with other individuals who are not just trying to run a law firm, but actually grow their law firm, to grow a business, to develop a lifestyle that is supported by their business. So I'm just excited about that piece as well. And of course, giving a presentation.
Of course, of course. No, the vibe out there is going to be amazing. It really is. The last couple of conferences we've done has just been amazing. All right, last question. If people want to get in touch with you, how do they get in touch with you?
Sure, you can contact me, and here's my direct, my cell is 860-818-2123. I do have special instructions. Text me first, because then I'll know when's a good time to call you. Or you can email us at familyfirst@thechristielawfirm.com. Again, that's familyfirst@thechristielawfirm.com.
I love it. Thank you so much, Nicole. I will talk to you soon. See you.
All right. Take care. Bye-bye.